Welcome to a brief demonstration of the power of Alteryx for converting spreadsheet data into a PDF report for people's payslips. First thing I'm going to do is run the workflow so you can see the data coming in and the resultant reports. If we look at the data coming in, you can see we have a spreadsheet here, traditional column format. And if we look at the resultant output of the workflow, we've got three different reports created for an individual for a set month and their payslip. If I click on one of these reports, we have two data cleansing and autofill tools just to tidy up the data, a select tool here to rename some of the columns to make them a little bit more user-friendly. First calculation produces the gross payable to the employee, so their gross pay plus their expenses. We're then going to filter out some data that we don't need. So the first filtering out here, we're going to remove employees who no longer work for us and any prior year data, so prior to 2019. Then we're going to filter to current year, because if we take a quick look at the false anchor here on this filter tool, we can see this populates pre-forward, so we have year data for 2020. We're not interested in that. So coming back to the true anchor, when we looked at that report, you will note that not only do we have current month data, but we have data for year to date. So we produce two work streams here. One area here that this will produce the total paid to date so far for the employee. So if we look at the this tool here, you can see here we have a sum for each employee of their gross pay, their tax paid, and their social security. And then coming down here, we filter down just so we're looking at December, which was the current month. We then calculate the deductions. So the deductions for the employee is how much tax they pay and how much social security. We then join this data back together. So for each individual employee, their record shows both the year-to-date data and the current month data. We've then used some date formatting tools so that from here we can extract the current year for reporting. We've converted the date so it's better date format for the report. We've then created a heading. So you'll see across to the right here, we create a heading. This is used, as you saw, the report formatting was employee name and the date and payslip. Again, you'll notice we've got some slightly untidy data. We've got some trailing spaces. So a quick data cleanse tool will tidy that up and remove trailing and leading white spaces. Now, you can see now we've got three different containers producing different parts of the payslip. So if we have a look at just the heading section, you can see here, so we have the employee details. The employee details is their employee names. We bring out the fields that we require here. And the company logo. Click on that, you can see it brings in the logo. We then use another join tool. Here we use a join from multiple sources, join those bits together, and then lay them out in a section. So that section is laid out so that we have that information going across. We repeat this process for each of the areas of the report. So we have our heading, this month's payments, year to date. You'll also see we have a company footer. That's a very simple text element. Again, once each of those individual sections, again, we join them back together using a join multiple. So you can see each section has an area. So we've got the footer, the year to date, this month's data, and the heading data. We then lay it out in a grid, how we would like that information laid out and in what order. So we have the header at the top, a layout section, year to date, and the footer. Then the final element is to render that report. And in rendering that report, we can decide what type of file format we want to go out to. We're producing a PDF. We can use other report formats like Word. This here is the calculated field I pointed out earlier. So we've got the header month employee. So this will group by each individual employee, producing that one report, how we want it laid out, and some report formatting. Okay, so to summarize, we go from spreadsheet, a running spreadsheet of all payroll, and produce an individualized personal payslip. Thank you for watching.